Thanks for inviting me. Today I want to talk about building smart AI and how a naive application of deep learning can actually get you into deep trouble. And I don't mean to sound alarmist, but I think the point should be made that with any technology, it can be used for good or evil, right? Nuclear energy can be used to illuminate the world and or blow up the world. And so I want to speak to our responsibility as data scientists to be taking these tools and methodologies and applying them in a smart way, and not just getting seduced by the sexy new thing that's out there. As I've surveyed the literature and seen what models have become in vogue, I've seen this trend, right? We start, I think really, you know, the 90s was sort of the heyday for, or even earlier, heyday for statistics and econometrics. Those are relatively transparent models, linear models, logistic regressions, things of that nature. Over time, we really shifted towards machine learning, right? And the newest models were support vector machines, random forest boosted trees. That got really popular. And now, what is it that everyone's talking about? It's deep learning, right? We've gotten really excited about the potential for deep learning to do even better than all of those previous models. And the fact of the matter is they do perform, for the right tasks, they perform better, right? I think that's pretty undeniable. But as we've shifted from these transparent models, from statistics and econometrics to machine learning to deep learning, I think we've actually lost something in the process. And I think those two things, first, is causal inference. So people may not realize this, as an econometrician, kind of I sit there and I wonder, well, what is it that makes me special? You know, why do I still exist in a world of data science that seems to be very dominated by engineers? The one thing econometricians are taught very well is causal inference, right? It's a really hard thing to do, to demonstrate that X is causally related to Y, and it's not being driven by Y, and both variables aren't being driven by a third unobserved variable. It's hard to do unless you can run experiments, which many of the people in this room may be able to do. If you're doing a retrospective study, causal inference is very hard to do. However, we've shifted away from that. I think over time, we've said, you know what? The problems we're encountering in technology, we don't care about causal inference as much as being able to predict an outcome. We don't care if the things we're measuring predict it. We just want to know, hey, is someone going to click on the buy button? And if they are, we can handle that differently than someone who we think is unlikely to be engaged. But I believe that that constitutes the why. Why are two variables related, or are they actually causally related at all? So I think in this shift, we really lost the why, and I'll give you guys a couple examples of why losing the why is actually problematic and something to be cause for concern. The second, and I think no one would disagree with this, transparent models. The fact of the matter is with all of those statistics and econometric models that I was trained in, if you give me enough scratch paper and pen, I can replicate those results. It's not fun, but for those of us who can do some matrix algebra and matrix math, they're all transparent. I can tell you exactly how that math was done to generate whatever solution you guys are seeing on your computer screen. We can't do that anymore. As we've shifted to those boosted trees, towards random forests, and especially towards any number of neural nets, we've trained the machines because we know these algorithms perform better than those transparent models, but we can't replicate them. And in many cases, we can't even explain why it is the machine came to the solution that it did, right? And I think that's cause for concern because I believe that represents the how, which is as we shift to black boxes, it becomes increasingly difficult to peer under the hood and to understand, well, in what direction are these variables related? Are we looking at some linear relationship, something U-shaped? We just know that, again, we're predicting better, we're happy with that, but we don't understand what variables are influencing that outcome in what direction.